PCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.
Welcome to the Institute Presents. I'm Susan Rohn, the Executive Director. And today we have with us Tammy Updegrove. Welcome, Tammy. Tammy is a very integral part of our faculty, and she's also a very talented and gifted artist. And the topic we're going to discuss with her today is about her upcoming exhibit, which opens May 18th, Thursday, May 18th, yes, from 5 until 8. And it's about healing through the arts. Tammy's had some difficult times in her life, as many of us have, and how she got through them. And this is the subject of the exhibit, and we're going to talk a little bit about it today, and just to get a perspective on how she's coming through this, how she got through it, and how she wants to help others, and how she thinks this can help others. So Tammy, I'm really happy that you did this exhibit. You were originally going to do it somewhere else, mm-hmm, and we just happened to be talking in the one of the art rooms,
right,
and you brought it up.
I did. It's thank you for having me, and I just I'm very happy that the Institute is embracing this as much as I am, and that we can share this and get the message out, because I do think everyone struggles in their life, and everyone, even if you're not an artist, you can use art as a tool to work through it. And it's just about my journey. And you'll see throughout that it started in a dark place, but I moved through. And there's lots of coping skills that I put out there and things I found.
Well, tell us a little bit about the journey. Tell us about, well, where you came from, how you moved through it, how you actually grasped onto the art, which was an integral part of who you are.
It is who I am, and I gave it up for a long time, and I think that's part of why I, other than teaching, I gave it up personally.
Oh, you weren't creating art.
I was not creating art, and I think that that was probably not a good thing for me, because it is part of who I am. But through a lot of despair in my personal life, everything was closing in, and I felt trapped, and I felt just there was no way out.
It was almost like a lifeline.
Yeah.
It was your lifeline.
Yes, the art then became my lifeline, but I didn't discover it at first. And actually, our good friend who we work with, Rich Halk.
Rich Halk?
Yeah, I came from therapy one day, and he said, you know what, I'm going to give you a giant piece of canvas. I want you to go home and throw paint on it. And I said, okay. And I did. It used billboard, recycled, and I went home and I threw the paint, but that wasn't enough for me. I just jumped on top of it. Mm-hmm. And then I started mixing the colors, and I started painting with my hands, and pretty soon it became this giant face with tears streaming down, and I used no brushes, it was all finger painting. And then I got up and threw more, and it was a process. I lived with my brother at the time, mm-hmm, and he had told my sister-in-law, look at her go, I should be taping her. Mm-hmm. And he didn't, but you know, then I thought, well, I could lose myself, even if it was just for a minute, in the paint. The smell of the paint, the sound of it slapping against the canvas, the feel, everything. Just to go away from my head, what was in my head, for just a minute or two. And then every day,
I became another minute.
That's right.
Another minute.
That's
is
right.
Is this one of the, I don't know if you
that
can see
is
that.
One of the large.
Is this one of the ones that you were doing when you were throwing paint?
Uh-huh. Yeah. So it's not, artistically, that is not a very, it's expressionistic. That's
actually,
what it is. It's abstract expressionism. is what those things are. I have a lot in the show, some realistic work as well, but that was part of the healing. So it's not so much about the fact that the eyes don't match, because they don't. Above her, there is drips of black paint, which is the darkness that just came over me. So I'm
showing
that.
Well, it got people's attention. It really did. And
but I guess the point of the show is I didn't want to stay there. I didn't want to stay where the darkness was, and the more I did, the better I felt. And then I started giving myself little tools, writing it down. That's okay, let's remember that negative self-talk is not going to help me fly. So that's when I started creating the pen and ink and things like that. So
more
I have some
positive things.
Right. Just to hang on the wall and
we're
look
reaching
at
out. We're climbing out of it.
That's right.
And we have a number
this is actually
of things. Okay.
Climbing out of it. This is
we get that.
So I felt stuck in underneath, stuck inside that darkness, but I knew that I could peek out from it once in a while. And so that is that.
That was the beginning.
Captured. Yeah, that's
pretty much
the
beginning. Of coming out of it.
Right.
You could see.
Right.
Light at the end of the tunnel.
Yeah, that
somewhere.
Was the hope.
Long tunnel.
Long tunnel. Long time.
Now that's one of them in the show. How many pieces do we have in the show? Do you know?
It's about 50.
50 pieces of all different sizes. Now I understand.
All different sizes, all different techniques, different mediums. Is that good if I move that now?
I understand you have some very large pieces.
I do have large pieces. That would be those would be the canvases that I threw paint on.
Okay, now
so we'll be sharing that as well.
I have a number of paintings from the show, three. I know you have some, too.
Mm-hmm.
Can we look at them now? Is now a good time
to
look
at them? Yeah, that's great. Yeah.
Okay, why don't we, here we go. We start with this one. Tell us about this.
So I actually got one of the old dictionaries my son took out of our old house.
I see the print in it.
That's right, and I wanted the words to show. So dictionary pages that meant something to me. And to persevere through something like this, which is a flower growing up out of concrete, basically, or blacktop. That's so the picture is representing that, but also the words are there.
Yes, and I see it's persevere.
Yeah.
And that's persevere. The dictionary. That's the word.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. Yes. That, okay. So that was more coming out of your...
That's right. As a reminder, a coping tool for myself, you know, painted it, put it up on the wall, and then I could look at it. Because even when you're not feeling, it's not an instant cure. And so the more you look at something like that, the more you're putting positive thoughts in your head, the better you get, the healthier you get.
Okay, let's go on to the next one.
That's another one as well. That one is perseverance, I believe.
Is what?
Is that one perseverance? The meaning, it's up there in the tree.
It says perseverance?
Yeah.
Also?
Okay, so that one is a tree growing out of boulders on the side of a mountain.
Very
it's
unusual.
Difficult, but it can be done. And that's what I wanted to share.
That's what you're sharing with people.
That's
okay.
Right.
And then we have this one.
That, again, was me in the center of a bird and that heavy weight is negative self-talk. And I think we all do that to some degree in our life.
And many different levels.
Lots of different levels, but all of it is really unhealthy way to think. So if you can just replace a little of that, like, oh, you look in the mirror and you think, oh, I'm not thin enough, I'm not pretty enough, I'm not, whatever. If it's that, if it's that little, you can start to change, well, yeah, okay, I look good today, or whatever it is that you can make yourself feel better. Now, that wasn't the degree that I'm talking about, but still, to replace negative thoughts, guilt, terrible things that happen in your life, you can change
that you don't let go of.
That's right, that you don't let go of. And that really gets you nowhere. So,
because it
keeps you in that bad spot.
Yes, it keeps your self-image.
That's right.
From being positive.
That's right. Prevents you from flying. So again, that's just a self tool, but I think people can relate to it.
After this, mm-hmm. Do you have anything that shows after this?
Well, I started finding, and this is kind of crazy because I'm not really a photographer, but I started finding random hearts throughout. Throughout my life, it was kind of weird. A couple of a week, this was snow, and it was on blacktop, and I saw a heart. I walked my dog every day. Gum that was left on the sidewalk, I would see a heart. Cracks in the sidewalks, I would see a heart. One day, I saw a cloud that was a heart. If you can't do art, if you feel that you can't create something that your mind wants to create with your hands, you can look for beauty in the world to keep you going.
Well, symbol, the heart became the symbol of hope.
It did.
Is that what it became?
It did. And I don't know, you know, where it was coming from, but it did keep me going. And it made me smile every time I found one.
So you're still looking for them?
I'm not even looking for them. That's the weird part. They just appear.
Because it's been...
Sometimes they take my breath away.
It's integrated into you.
I guess.
Okay.
But I thought, you know what? That's pretty cool. I'm going to share that with people, too. Because...
And we all may have some symbol.
Yeah,
something even that goes back in time, like something your grandmother loved.
That's right.
And it's funny how those things show up.
It is funny.
At unusual times, and you don't think about them for years, and all of a sudden there's something there, and it's almost at a time in your life when you need it.
When you need it.
It's very interesting.
And actually, I didn't get those signs until I started to let go of the negative
and
stuff.
And started thinking positively.
Right. And then they started showing up.
You have some other things with you, too.
I have another piece that I brought today, and this one, again, is from the dictionary pages, but this one is courage. So to me, I thought maybe a girl walking across on a tightrope from one cliff to the other, that would take courage to do. But even if you're fighting an illness, you need courage to do it.
To keep going. To not give up.
That's right.
And that's the journey you've had.
That is the journey I had. I did give up at one point. I gave up and I survived it. And this is what I want to share. I never thought, truthfully, that I could get out of it, that I would ever have lightness in my life again. I did not see that.
And it was through the art.
It was through the art.
Your child
therapy
appearing at some point
and saying, hey, go to throw. I have thanked him for that numerous times. But yeah, that really did help me refocus.
How long ago was that?
2.5 years.
2.5 years ago, he told you to go throw paint.
Mm-hmm. Now, even before that time, because I actually did try to commit suicide, and it was a really bad time in my life, and I was surrounded by a lot of horrible things. And so there was a point when I was at the beach, and I knew, because okay, that didn't work, so now I'm here on earth, so how am I going to keep going? Because I was still surrounded by a lot of negativity. So I'm on the beach, and I looked down at my feet, and they were planted in the sand, and that's when I took a picture of my feet and said, okay, I cannot rely on people right now, but I am here on the earth and I'm going to connect to this to keep me there. So I did snap that picture even before Rich talked to me about that, because I knew I had to find something to stay connected to.
Stable.
Something I could count on.
And my feet in the sand
at that point, yes.
And in your artist statement, you mentioned that. Mm-hmm. That you have to be connected to the earth.
Right, so that was the first.
It's your way of coping.
And staying. Mm-hmm. So then since then, though, everything changed. I have really wonderful, happy, healthy relationships now. Even with people beforehand that I didn't think I could reach out to and say, hey, I'm feeling this way. Mm-hmm. Now I know, yes, I can. Yes, I can. So as bad as you are in the moment, it can, if you just get past it, it can get better. It can.
But it takes internal.
It takes a lot, 42. But you can. Sometimes you have to change your surroundings as well.
Okay. Did you change yours?
Yes.
You did?
Major changes in my life.
Okay. And then everything came at once, and then it came together. Ultimately,
yes.
You came out of it.
Yes.
Well, you're having a workshop.
Yes, I am.
On May 21st. This show opens May 18th, Thursday mm-hmm. night.
Right.
But May 21st, the following Sunday, mm-hmm. you're having a workshop, I believe, at 1 o'clock, isn't it? 1
yes.
to 2?
1 to 2.
Tell us about that.
I'll be painting live. Now, throughout the show, even on Thursday night, I would like to have stations set up. Mm-hmm. One of the stations would be where people could collage, because ripping things, cutting things when you're angry or frustrated is actually really therapeutic. And then taking those pieces and rebuilding, like possibly finding a happy word or a word in a magazine clipping that might mean something to you personally. Then you put that,
especially
you glue that on. That's right.
Because it gives you a snapshot of where you were.
That's right. So
is
you'll
that
see,
how it works?
Yes, and you'll see some of my collage work also through the show, and I'll put that near the station, but I want it to be about what people create to help them. Even sometimes it's a silly face. Like I also collaged a bunch of cats one day because they were making silly faces. Mm-hmm. So then I could
cats are fun.
Gape. Yes.
Fun.
And my puppy, she 9 pounds, 2 ounces of therapy. She my fluffy therapy dog. But sometimes you get funny videos, whatever, to get lost in that moment. So my workshop is gonna be things like a collage station. And another thing which sounds kind of crazy, but I actually do have some
bubble wrap
that I thought what we could do with this bubble wrap is so you kind of think of a problem or something that's really bothering you, and you visualize that in the bubble, and then you pop it.
You should have that all over the institute.
Yes, that's what we do just all the time.
Yes, what makes so much noise?
Yes.
But we should do that.
Yeah. So there is, again, something that I just thought, you know what? I'm really mad today. You just let it out and pop. But then also you could do something cool with this, and you can paint colors on this and then press it into paper. Mm-hmm. And that can even be part of your collage, or it can be separate.
We have lots of that at the Institute.
Yeah, yeah.
We have a huge roll of it.
Oh, cool.
I'm sure Rich got it.
I have a ton of stuff, too, and I just have been collecting because I wanted to share it. So those are the kind of things. Now, we won't have a smashing mosaic section, but that is also...
That could be dangerous.
On a personal, yes, on a personal level, that's always... Yeah, safety first. You wear your goggles and your gloves, but... It's also very therapeutic to take a hammer and smash some plates or, you know,
that's
whatever
at the time.
That's why
people throw things at walls sometimes.
That is why maybe we should have one of those.
Just throw a glass or throw something across the room and say, I've just had it.
Yeah, right. But, and then other things helped me as well. I went to the gym a lot. I ran. It's all
great.
That stuff that ties together. And yoga, because you're silencing your mind. Yeah, so it's been quite a journey, but I feel like if I can just get one person to try it before they totally give up, then I've done something.
And they've succeeded.
Yes, and hopefully I can reach a lot more, especially today with younger folks. This is for everybody, but younger kids in school, and you have a lot of pressures, mm-hmm. and maybe you don't know how to have an outlet that's healthy, mm-hmm. instead of looking for... the drugs or something, maybe try throwing paint. Maybe try smashing a plate. Maybe, you know, because mm-hmm. I understand that. We all go through grief in our life and parts of depression. I think every single person does.
At some point.
It's
how they handle
yes.
and react and how long.
That's right.
Yeah, I think I could agree with that, thinking about it. You know, you have times in your life when things happen.
Yes.
You bounce.
Yes.
But
right.
Some people don't bounce as quickly as others.
Sometimes you get stuck.
That's what happens. Mm-hmm. It can happen, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Well, this has been quite an interesting conversation, really. And the exhibit itself will have workstations
yes.
and things around it.
Yes, and then on that Sunday, I will be painting live. I'll take a giant canvas. I won't be throwing it because it's on the stage, but I will immerse myself in it and paint.
Okay. So that's from 1 to 2, and then at 4
right.
o'clock, we have Rohn Chandler coming.
Oh, yes, I'll have it all cleaned up.
Well, I think you could stay and relax after all that expression.
That's
after
right.
all the self-expression, they can all stay for Irwin's concert.
Yeah.
That would be wonderful. Yes, it would be. It's well, this is a very interesting exhibit and concept, and you are reaching out to the community. And
I want everyone to come. I don't feel like you have to come to see the art. I want people to come and feel comfortable. And, you know, maybe know that someone else has felt this way, and hey, here she is now.
Yeah. And how you can reach out to others, too, if
that's
you
right.
see someone who you feel is going through this.
That's right.
Have you seen the suicide prevention production the Institute does with the teens?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That segues right into
it really does.
What's happening here, and we thought on many levels this exhibit was fitting into what we do.
Right.
So I really thank you for having the courage to do this.
Thanks.
And come forward with it.
Thank you.
And we're all looking forward to the opening.
Thanks.
And the workshop. And we're going to move on before we end, because our time's about up. I just remind people that Rohn Chandler is at the Institute on May 21st, right after Tammy's workshop, about an hour or two later, and that we have camp starting the week of June 12th, and Tammy mm-hmm. is a toddler teacher.
I'm a toddler teacher.
She
and
does
I'm
a visual
arts. Arts teacher. Yeah, so in the morning we do the toddlers, and in the afternoon we do all the camps that are age 3 through 12,
mm-hmm.
and the children rotate mm-hmm. among the yeah. disciplines of art.
Yeah. I think it's 3 to 10 now, and
is
then I think there's
ten?
A 10 to, there's
okay.
an older classes for older kids
for
in the afternoon.
That's wonderful.
I think the integrated arts are basically 3 to 10.
Right.
But the two-year-olds are always exciting.
Yes, I just
What's the advantage
them.
Of sending your child to camp at 2 years old?
Because they get a taste for, well, friendship and doing things together. They dance, and we do visual arts every single day, and this is a great place to get messy and feel mm-hmm. comfortable doing that. Mm-hmm. And it's a wonderful introduction. We've heard, I've been teaching 10 years there this
That's,
summer.
My goodness,
so,
that went so fast.
Yes,
I was trying to think about that the other day. How long has it been?
10 years. I've been doing this camp,
here.
So it was a little bit longer than that because I started at night. But I've had a lot of parents who said that was a great introduction, and our children did really well come fall because mm-hmm. they had that little taste of being away from mom and dad. We give them lots of hugs and kisses, and sometimes there's tears at first, but boy, by the end, they're really comfortable, and it's fun.
It's a good socialization tool.
Yeah.
It really
yeah.
is. Uh-huh. And it is 5 days a week. It's a different camp each week. And we have had people say, well, why 5 days? Why don't we do every other day? Mm. We tried that. It was like a nightmare. Because the children would get used to it the first day. Then they'd be home the second
yeah,
day. And then the third
right.
day, they'd come back and they'd be screaming all over. You know,
yeah.
it would be upsetting
mm-hmm.
to some of them.
Yes.
Some of them were fine. Most of them, quite a few of them were not, though.
Right, because a lot of times this
so
is
the first consistency of 5 days. Is really very helpful.
Yeah, I think so.
And having a patient teacher that really loves the children and sees their creativity and how they can express themselves is very helpful too. So anyway, we have camp starting June 12th, and we also have our summer session starting June 19th, Monday a week later. That will be online probably in the next couple weeks, and you'll also be getting a brochure in the mail, we hope, as soon as we get everything together. We've had server problems and computer problems, but hopefully after today, they're behind us. And don't forget the dance recital, June 10th at Berks Catholic. It's at 2 in the afternoon. So until next month, I thank you for joining us, and we'll see you in June.
CCTV receives state arts funding support through a grant from the Pennsylvania Council on the Arts, a state agency. Funded by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and the National Endowment for the Arts, a federal agency.